The irate farmers.
Yeah, with shotguns.
Yeah.
And fences.
Yep, that's it.
Wheat.
That's the first wheat field I've seen.
Right, yeah. Let's give this camera some footage.
Having reunited in Volgograd, myself and Terry, now with his suspension fully back in order, raced along the open, fast steppe country east of the Volga River. The terrain was mostly predictable, flat hardpack, and our trails were primarily tractor trails along the edge of farms. The riding was fast and fun. The weather was dry, sunny and warm, and to our pleasant surprise, we found we had good 3G phone coverage everywhere we went. Our route took us parallel to the Kazakhstan border. Russia has closed border zones up to 50 kilometers inside its borders. We needed to ensure we did not encroach on any border zones, because if we were caught inside them without a permit, as foreigners we could be jailed and expelled from Russia for 5 years or more. These were carefree days, and it drove home to me how much I really enjoyed riding with Terry. While his personality is jovial and easy to get along with, he takes his motorcycle seriously and assesses the risks well. I knew I could rely on him to prep his bike thoroughly before the trip. I knew he had traveled in Russia before and wasn't put off by its sometimes quirky ways. In fact, he loved it as much as I did. All in all, I knew I could switch off my worries and just focus on riding along at a pace I enjoyed, since Terry enjoyed the same pace.
There's no track here. Well, there should be one right about here. But there's absolutely not. Let's go back, turn around the other way.
We didn't have it all our own way. There were still a few bits where the track just didn't exist, and we had to improvise and pick up the track a mile or two further on.
Kept the speed high in the steppe country, spending most of our time between 70 and 120 kilometers an hour, with bursts up to 135. We needed to keep the speed up to cover the demanding daily mileage required to complete the Sibirsky Extreme Trail in time. Riding the trail takes a full summer season, and the average daily off-road mileage required is high, around 300 off-road kilometers per day. When the riding conditions are fast and good, that needs to be up around 400 kilometers or more per riding day.
It's deeper here, and wider, and soggier, and
ruts in there.
And there's ruts. Right. We're about to attempt the first major water crossing of Sibirsky Extreme 2012. Didn't really expect water crossings out here on the Russian Steppe, but it is what it is. And Terry, of course, is going to go first.
The water crossing wasn't significant, but as the first one in the trip, we did have to psych ourselves up for it a bit. Also, the crossing was in the middle of the steppe, which usually means muddy, boggy crossings. In hilly terrain, you're far more likely to get clear water flowing over a solid base of stones, but in the flatlands, the crossings tend to be still, muddy and sticky. Paths frequently diverge from the track we were meant to be on. By having the GPS unit as high as possible on the bike's dashboard, I was able to make quick calls at each trail junction, on the move, and stay on track without sacrificing time slowing down.
Fun. We probably should see if we can find some petrol here.